Welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name is Travis and this is Bacon and Backpacking, and I'm super excited because today we are in the Oil Creek State Park in Pennsylvania, and as you can see, we've got a little miniature winter wonderland. So I've been waiting to do a trip in the snow so far this winter, and this is the first one, so I'm super excited. There was no snow in the forecast, but here we are. There are a bunch of different trail systems out here, but the main one, the backpacking one, is the Gerard Trail. I believe it is a 36-mile trail that goes around both sides of Oil Creek. And there's a view of some of the hills out here. I'm starting to sweat already, first mile, so the flannel's gonna have to come off. Got my water filter in that pocket because it is below freezing. I'm gonna start sweating a whole bunch, and that's not good with the low being 22 tonight, so keep on keeping on. And this is why you guys need to go backpacking in the winter. So in the summer, or when the leaves are on, we're not seeing that ridge, opposite us, right? But in the winter time, you can see much more of the topography of an area, which makes things way more exciting than they otherwise would be if it's just like a green or a brown tunnel, right? So I feel kind of bad because Sarah and I went on a trip last weekend to Laurel Highlands, which is also in PA, and she had an appointment today that she had to make, so she couldn't come today. And she's like, "I'm gonna be so mad at you if it snows out there." I said, "Don't worry about it. There's nothing in the forecast. Like, not even a registered chance of snow Friday, Saturday, and Sunday." Well, it snowed last night, Friday. It's snowing today, Saturday. So who knows? I mean, I have no idea how much we'll end up getting, but all I know is let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Well, here's the biggest structure we've seen so far. Take a look. Get a little bit closer here, see what's going on. Okay, there it is. Probably shouldn't spend too much time in here considering the stuff that's holding it up is falling down, but pretty cool. Check out this other room. Looks like we got another structure down here. Let's see what we got. Well, whatever they had sitting here on this foundation is gone, but still pretty cool. That must be Greg Falls. See if we can get you guys down here, take a little bit closer of a look, get a better shot, but there she is. You know, I was wondering how big this thing was. I didn't see any pictures or videos of it, but it's pretty sizable and pretty good water flow right now too. Nice. Well, let's get a parting shot of Greg Falls in the background there. I'm starting to get a little bit hungry, so I might stop and grab a snack here pretty shortly. So if you've been paying attention, we've been following yellow blazes the whole time, and now we're following some white because there's an intersection back there, and I hopped off on a side trail that's gonna take me to a place called Pioneer, and I guess there's a bunch of equipment down there. So we're gonna go check that out, see if that's, you know, cool or what the deal is with that, and then we're gonna link back up with the backpacking trail. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is Oil Creek. Oh my goodness. Look how freaking beautiful. This turned out to be a, a great trip. I mean, this is why you go backpacking in the winter, everybody. Look at that. Man, wouldn't trade this for anything. We gotta go that way though. Oh man, we gotta get a move on. Come down here. I think we're like a quarter mile from this Pioneer site or whatever, but I've been recording a ton of stuff, and then, you know, even just stuff I'm not recording, I've just been kind of like stopping to, you know, just be present and you know, admire the beauty out here. I mean, it's been a full year since I've been out hiking in the snow. You know, last winter, I just never really caught any snow, like when I go out on trips. We're catching some today, huh? Beautiful. If you guys aren't backpacking out in the winter in the snow, you need to. I have a bunch of videos on my page to help you out with, you know, doing that in the cold weather and staying safe, staying warm, and having a good time. So if you guys are liking what you're seeing so far and you want to get into winter backpacking, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and check out some of those other videos I have on the subject. Well, this must be it. Oh man, it is friggin' dank in here. I'll eat a couple pieces of jerky here. and I like my Cliff Bar on the go. You know, it's been snowing the whole time, and I'm not really cold or anything, but you know, I don't want that snow to start accumulating on my base layers and you know, start getting me wet. You know, that's going to be some of the clothes I'm going to sleep in, so want to make sure those stay dry. And wind's picking up a little bit too, not bad, but enough to be annoying, so we might end up finishing out this hike with the frog togs on. So I think I'm gonna put some miles in. I've been kind of, you know, just enjoying what's around me, and I've been recording a bunch and stopping a bunch, so you know, it's time to put my head down a little bit, get some miles in. So there's like a freaking old bus or something back there, and I really want to go check it out. And I actually saw it on somebody else's video, but there are posted signs everywhere. So that's definitely private property, so we're gonna respect that. And especially in the middle of gun season, almost fell down, but yeah, especially in the middle of gun season, not gonna be walking onto somebody else's property. I apologize for the audio because I have to constantly charge my phone out here in this cold weather. So I don't want to unhook everything, but what if you had to get this on the phone? There's people down there walking the bridge. Beautiful view. Well, we're about 6 1/4 miles in, so means we should have about 2 miles left till we get to camp. Nice, peaceful, quiet woods. Nice hike. Not too hard, not too easy. Scenery's nice. But yeah, I think we have a stream that leads right up into camp. So we'll stop, fill up water right before we get into camp, and get all set up and ready to rock and roll for the night. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are here. I didn't see a sign that said whether or not this was like tent, you know, campsite number one, number two, whatever, but it was the first one. So I'm assuming this is site number one, and I don't think there's anybody else that's staying outside of the shelters. I think there's like 5 shelters down there, and I saw fires in at least 3 of them. So we got plenty of neighbors, which I was kind of surprised, but everybody's in the shelters and has them all tented off and everything. It's pretty funny, but I think we've got some trees right here. I think this is where we're gonna set up the hammock for the night. Cooling down a little bit, my fingers and toes are pretty cold, so. Hammock's all set up, ready to rock and roll. So I think next priority here is gonna be to change my socks. And then after that, I think we might try to work on a fire here. Oh. We have fire. Oh man, needed that. You know, as always, guys, thanks for tuning in. Hope you're enjoying the video. I'll get a couple other things on here tonight. You know, I'll show you guys like what the temperature's like and everything like that. And we'll probably get a couple more shots of, you know, the fire. But I'm just going to take care of myself here. I'm going to get warm and I'm going to eat some food because I really need that. And we're going to go from there. We got our food. I've got a Knorr rice cheddar broccoli side and two packets of the chicken that you get like at Walmart or whatever. So I don't know if you can see, but I've got this entire pot full of this. So this is going to be a big, you know, hearty meal because I'm probably not going to stay up super late. You know, I mean, I'm out here by myself, you know, it's already dark. And, you know, I'll chill around the fire for like a little bit, but, you know, it's probably going to be an early night tonight. I hit the spot. Just got some stuff drying. The pair of socks I have on's warm. Those are almost dry. And then I have a pair of sleeping socks as well too. So fire's going well. Got my water over here and my fuel canister just close enough that, you know, they don't freeze. But obviously we don't want to get any of that stuff too close because it'll melt and or explode. But yeah, we're just kind of chilling. It's about 6:30, so I'm probably gonna do like maybe another hour out here, then I'm gonna hang my food and it's gonna be bedtime. All right, everybody. Well, it's about 8 o'clock and I think that means it's time for me to hit the hay. So hopefully I sleep like 11 hours. That would be nice, but there's the hammock setup. That's home for the night. So for those of you that are new to the channel, everything here is from Warbonnet. That is the mountain fly tarp. That is the 20 degree Wookie underquilt. And then in there is the 20 degree Diamondback top quilt. And then this is the Warbonnet Blackbird. It is freaking cold, guys. And we're gonna make some food, we're gonna pack up, and we're gonna get moving because I really wanna start getting some blood flow to my body. It was, you know, I slept good and everything. You know, all the gear did its job. You know, I stayed plenty warm and everything. Tried to keep this canister in my pocket for a while, maybe warm it up a little bit, but we'll see. Still coughing from that flu I had a week and a half ago. It's really hard to shake that, you know, in the winter, especially whenever, you know, I've been outside the last 2 weeks, so a little bit of ice in the water bottle there. So I showed you guys that thermometer. You know, when I first took it out of my pack, it said that it was 18 degrees on there, and then just me holding it and walking over and fumbling with the camera to try to turn it on, you know, me holding it in my hands warmed it up to 20. But it's about 18 degrees Fahrenheit right now. Got some Taster's Choice coffee in here, and I also put some hot chocolate in there. Kodiak protein oats. This is the maple and brown sugar. This is probably probably the best one I've had so far. This stuff's good, man. Oh yeah. I got a Hanukkah party to get to tonight. And no, I'm not Jewish. But I gotta drive back to Ohio and, you know, hang up all my gear that's wet and all that fun jazz. So I'll record what I can, but I think it's gonna be a short day of recording on the way out. All right, everybody, we'll show you some stuff now that we got some daylight here. So this was our picnic table and fire ring right here. And we came in up this way. I'll show you the wood pile. Plenty of wood. I mean, I think we had three different neighbors and we didn't really put too much of a dent in it. There's a split and maul, a couple different big stumps there where you could split down the smaller pieces if you want. But yeah, guys, we're gonna head out because my toes are cold and I wanna get moving. Yeah, I don't see any smoke coming out the chimney here, so I don't think there's anybody in this one. So we'll show you real quick. Pretty similar to Laurel Highlands. Fire pit. There's no grill on that one though. That'd be worth noting. There's no grill on the fire pit, at least not on this one, but there she is. And without further ado, we are Oscar Mike for day two. Poet, you didn't know it. Oh man, guys, it's cold. Like I said, you know, it was about 18 degrees. That was about 40 minutes ago though, so let's give it 20 maybe. And still putting down snow for the third day, you know, even though it wasn't supposed to, which just goes to show you, always be prepared. I'm gonna filter 1 liter of water here. I only drank about 1 liter all day yesterday until I got into camp. So, you know, I plan on just kind of beating feet and getting out of here today. So we're just gonna filter this 1 liter and that's it. Make sure you don't let this thing freeze or you might wake up with the scoots. Shake this bad boy out. Doesn't matter how many times you shake it out, it's still gonna have water in it. So that is why I keep it in a Ziploc bag so it doesn't leak inside my pocket or inside my quilt at night while I'm sleeping. Little shed. Let's see what's over here. Any animals living in here? Not really anything to see in there. Still pretty cool though. So we are now on the Oil Creek Trail, and as you could probably see behind me here, it's like a towpath type of trail. And typically, you know, that's not my favorite thing to do, but a couple things. One, I don't do out and backs. This is a 36 mile trail, and as you can see back here behind me, Oil Creek is more like Oil River, and there's only so many places you can cross that. And in order for me to get an amount of mileage done that I could do today, make it back to Ohio, make it to the party, I decided to, you know, make a loop using this trail. You know, I get to walk next to this the whole time, seeing the snow and how pretty everything is, hearing the sound of the water. I'm not gonna complain. And plus with the weather, I doubt we're gonna see too many people, you know, hiking this trail. Tell you guys what, say what you want, because we're hiking on a bike trail instead of, you know, in the backcountry woods, but man, I will walk along this all day, every day, any day that ends with a Y, man. So we hopped off of Oil Creek Trail, and this should look familiar from yesterday. This is Pioneer. Lots of deer tracks here. 3 miles left. I decided to go ahead and just retrace about the last 3 miles from yesterday. Died in 1826. Jeez. Had to walk down to the woods a couple hundred feet, but couldn't pass this up. That's a big wheel. I like the foundations to keep it, it's very swampy down here. For them to keep it up off the ground, I like their foundations there. It's pretty cool. Huh. Interesting structure. All right, everybody, I think we got less than a mile, so it's about that time. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Without you, there is no bacon and backpacking. With that being said, if you guys enjoyed watching me try not to freeze to death on this trip, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. If you want to see more freezing cold backpacking trips, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I'm out year round, and not only do I do trip videos, but I also do like gear reviews, tips and tricks, hacks. I've recently started a new backpacking for beginner series, so go ahead and check that out. Down in the description box, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and put a link to our Facebook group. It is called Backpacking Ohio and Beyond. Go ahead and join up on that. Right now, we are doing our first annual trip for the group, and that is gonna be in May, and it's gonna be in Dolly Sods, West Virginia. Now, if that first annual trip goes well, I'm definitely doing a second annual. I may even start doing a semi-annual, like a spring and a fall. And you know, who knows, maybe we'll do 4 or 5 a year. So it just all depends on, you know, what the attendance is. But I'd love to get a chance to meet some of you guys, you know, hit the trail with you, do some camping with you. But anyways, guys, like, subscribe, join the Facebook group, and we'll see you in the next one.